Well, breaking overnight, Boise police are investigating after a shot was fired during a protest in downtown Boise. Officers do believe this was accidental. We'll show you a look at the scene from the Idaho Statehouse from above. This video was taken overnight. CBS 2's Kristen McPeak is now live this morning on the ground there with more details on what unfolded. Kristen.
Good morning, Denny. After a night of protests here at the Statehouse, things are quiet right now. The last two people just left, and now maintenance crews are walking the grounds, just cleaning things up. Protests were peaceful, but at times things did get a little heated. Boise police say that one shot was accidentally fired and no one was hurt. So take a look at this video right here. This is a scene from last night. Protesters marched through downtown Boise and ended up back here at the Capitol chanting and waving signs. Police did have the roads blocked off until about 3 o'clock this morning. Now, I did speak with dispatch this morning, and they told me that there was only one call related to this protest last night, and that was that, quote, accidental shot. So we will keep you updated throughout the morning. Live in Boise, Kristen McPeak, CBS 2 News.
In a surreal moment, President Trump walked out of the White House and across the park to St. John's Church, which was set on fire just the night before. He held up a Bible, declaring,
"We have a great country. That's my thought."
Just moments earlier, the streets surrounding the White House devolved into chaos. Police, who were reinforced by members of the military ordered there by President Trump, pushed the crowds back. Demonstrators and media alike,
you see what's going on now,
forcibly removed and struck while retreating. President Trump announced he'd had enough.
I am dispatching thousands and thousands of heavily armed soldiers, military personnel, and law enforcement officers to stop the rioting, looting, vandalism.
A show of force seen at the U.S. Capitol, a perimeter of police protecting it, a second line of defense beyond that, as protesters again expressed anger at Washington. In a call Monday, Trump told governors to follow suit, deploy more of the National Guard.
You have to dominate. If you don't dominate, you're wasting your time. They're going to run over and look like a bunch of jerks.
Meanwhile, George Floyd's brother also denounced the violence and suggested a much different solution.
Let's stop thinking that our voice don't matter.
That's right.
And vote. Educate yourself and know who you're voting for. And that's how we're going to hit them.
Scott Logan talked with a director of the Idaho Labor Department, Janie Revere. Prior to coming to labor, Revere served as head of the Division of Financial Management for 6 years under former Governor Butch Otter. She explained to Scott what the Labor Department is doing to deal with this tsunami of unemployment claims caused by the pandemic.
Today is a big day for the Idaho Department of Labor. The agency opened a new call center, but guess what? No sooner had the call center opened than it was overwhelmed by calls. But Janie Revere, director of the Idaho Department of Labor, says they expect to get things squared away soon with the call center, which is a network of people spread around the country.
The fact that we've got a call center to help us answer calls is a clear indication that we are overwhelmed. We cannot answer the number of calls that are coming into our office, and that's not an acceptable situation. That call center is kind of the front line, or the triage, if you will. They're going to be able to answer basic questions. They're going to be able to reset accounts if people lock themselves out.
Just a few months ago, the Labor Department was set to announce record low unemployment in Idaho, 2.5%. Then suddenly, COVID-19 blew up the unemployment rate to an all-time high of 11.5%.
This is a huge swing that we have seen, and as I alluded to earlier, a significant increase in the amount of Idahoans filing for unemployment insurance.
The department has added 19 additional claim specialists, but Revere says the agency still lacks enough adjudicators, those more knowledgeable employees who deal with more complicated claims.
You can't just hire an adjudicator off the street. We need to train them up through the process. And so our adjudicators usually come from our claim specialists.
A pre-pandemic claims adjudication could take up to 6 weeks, Revere says. But now there are so many of them. Plus, the state must administer 3 new and complex federal programs as well. Rivera says the agency's computer system is not a throwback to the 1970s, as some jobless Idahoans may suspect. In fact, the state has started moving its unemployment IT to a modernized cloud-based system.
So Idaho's fortunate that we have modernized our system. About 6 or 7 years ago, we came off the mainframe and we completely modernized our system. We're not in the cloud yet, but that's probably our next phase.
The Labor Department is also fighting a perception among many jobless Idahoans that the agency simply doesn't care about them. Revere, a fifth-generation Idahoan, says nothing is further from the truth.
The Department of Labor cares deeply about the citizens of Idaho and the unemployment insurance program. We are striving as quickly as we can to process these payments.
Idaho bars are reopened under stage 3 of the governor's order that began this weekend. CBS 2's Trevor Fay is in downtown Boise to see how things went.
That's the sound of life returning to downtown Boise. Bars and nightclubs again open, and business owners are catering to people's appetite for drink and fun. Ezra Jackson, owner of the Handlebar, is welcoming customers back within reason.
Just being cautious about what you're actually doing, we're definitely spreading people out.
The Handlebar had a good opening weekend, regulars returned, but the place wasn't packed. I asked if folks could still play bar games here.
Right now you still can, and you can bring up to a group of 6, but you have to bring your own games.
The bar even has tricycle races that they hold every Thursday. Although the races are on hold for now because of the pandemic, Ezra says he expects to have them back by midsummer. And it's not just tricycle races. Handlebar patrons can ride bicycles too. Jackson organizes community rides for his staff and customers.
If we can get everybody on a social ride and just explore the town and support the town, that's what our goal is.
Jackson is pleased with how the Handlebar is starting out after the quarantine. He says it'll probably be a little while before they're back to seeing pre-pandemic levels of customers. As for his future plans,
get some music back, get some social rides back, and just try to see what the next normal is.
Until then, they'll continue doing everything they can to keep healthy while they also have fun. In Boise, Trevor Fay, CBS 2 News.
Governor Little says Idaho's Phase 3 is projected to go until June 12th. After that, we'll see if we can move into Phase 4.